Let's now move on to working capital margin loaded as part of cost of project. Why working capital margin? Why it should be loaded under term loan cost? To understand that, let's look at this. Let's say your borrower A Limited is starting the business. It's their first project. Okay. Let's say it is taken up at the cost of 100 million. It is taken up at the cost of 100 million. Right. Now, for this, they have come for a loan. Let's say bank loan is 75 million and their own funds, whatever they had, own funds, they are investing, it is 25 million. Right. So, 100 million is the total cost and entire 100 million is funded. Now, this cost includes land and building, plant and machinery, then other related assets. Okay. They had only 25 million which they have invested fully. Fine. Now, they have availed the loan. They have acquired all this land and building, plant and machinery. It means they have state of art infrastructure. They have wonderful factory now. And when a customer visits this factory, he is ready to place order. He is ready to place order. Fine. Now, this customer wants to execute the order. The question is how he will execute the order. Because whatever money he had invested and he raised a bank loan of 75 million. But now he has no additional money to take up this order. It means he has no money for working capital. Okay, fine. Then bank says, don't worry, we'll sanction you working capital. Let's say something like 20 million. Bank says, we'll sanction you working capital 20 million. We'll give you this 20 million only when you bring in 5 million from your pocket. But how they'll bring? They had only 25 million which was fully invested in the project. And now the bank says, we are ready to give you 20 million provided you bring in 5 million. So what is this 5 million? 5 million is the margin which he is expected to bring, but he has already invested everything what he had. So in order to help him to come out of this strain, what the banking system will do, when they consider the total cost of project, they will also add this working capital margin. They will also add this working capital margin. In that case, cost of the project will not be 100 million. It will be 105 million. Okay, it will be 105. So, cost is 105. Maybe on 105, the bank will give loan of 75%. It means remaining 25% should come from promoters. It means bank may give another 3.75 and they are expected to bring in another 1.25. Okay, so this is something I think it should be manageable. They have to arrange for it because they cannot have free meal, complete free meal. Margin is their obligation. Bank is ready to fund, but the bank will fund only what they can fund. In our example, bank will fund only 75%. Okay, so they have to find way to bring in this 1.25, in which case own funds will become 26.25 and bank funds will become how much? 75 plus 3.75, 78.75, and the total is 105 million. Okay, so this is how working capital margin concept operates. Let's get into the presentation. This working capital margin can be included under cost of project, but again, which working capital margin will be financed? Because we know working capital requirement arises as a result of funds being getting logged in inventories and debtors. But in the initial stages, the investment required in inventory receivables may be less, right? There'll be less. So what banking system will do, they'll see what is the peak current asset level. I mean, at what point of time there'll be peak. So that will be considered. So look at here, margin requirement at peak current asset level during the first year of operations will be considered for this purpose. But please understand, margin for the first year of operation only provided under cost of project, and it is part funded through bank loan. It means margin requirement during further years should be made from internal generations, or promoter should infuse adequate capital for this purpose.